And then a further idea struck him, and once again he wondered if he had reached his solution. Had a delayed action device been used, and had it been, like all he had previously known, mechanical? Had the living snake been out of the picture altogether? French now saw that he had allowed himself to be obsessed with the idea of the living snake. Suppose the creature had been used only to supply venom, which had then been employed in some sort of mechanical striker. Suppose points had been arranged to prick the professor's hand, and suppose these points had been painted with the venom. He remembered reading of the rings used in the Middle Ages by the Borgias and like-minded gentry, and how, when shaking hands, the sharp point could be pressed into the victim's hand. Had some modern version of the Borgias' murders been committed? French turned his thoughts to the wound on Burnaby's hand. It had been assumed that he had been bitten while trying to ward the snake off, but instead, had he grasped something with poisoned points which had pricked him? The idea was certainly promising. French grew almost excited as he pursued it. Where exactly was the injury? On the palm of the right hand, near the base of the first and second fingers. French clasped his left hand with his right. Why, yes, that was the part of the hand which normally touched a grasped object. What could such an object have been? Something apparently connected with Burnaby's departure from home. What did a man grasp on leaving his house? Obviously a door handle. He would pull some door after him. Could poisoned spikes have been fixed to a door handle? And when Burnaby seized it to close the door, could he have pressed the spikes into his hand?